हेलो
दीपक,
सर। हाँ
हाय, हाउ आर यू?
आई एम गुड, आई एम गुड।
सो एज अ सरप्राइज, लाइक वी हैव वन ऑफ द नॉट वन ऑफ द मोस्ट एलिजिबल बैचलर फ्रॉम मुंबई,
अच्छा
दीपक सिंह. वी हैव गॉट दीपक सिंह ज्वाइनिंग अस टुडे. लेट मी इंट्रोड्यूस ऑल यू टू दीपक. I think at least few of you must be knowing Deepak already. Like you know, so Deepak was my client in the sense he was working with the formulation team in Microlabs. I think in 2014, for the first time I met him. I was working in IP that point of time. He's a basically a pharmacist, M-Pharm. Then as a traditional career, he chose the formulation department. एफ एंड डी में जॉब मिला तो हमें करना है करके. एंड देन लाइक यू नो आफ्टर सम टाइम देन ही जॉइंड इन आफ्टर सम इयर्स रादर गुड एक्सपीरियंस विद द एफ एंड डी ही जॉइंड गैंसेंस लिमिटेड विच इज मोर इन टू ऑफकोर्स ही वुड टेल यू वॉट गैंसेंस इज ऑल अबाउट एक्चुअली. ओके एज वेल एज सो नाउ ही इज इन्वॉल्व इन टू लाइक यू नो टेक्नो कमर्शियल मार्केटिंग. Although he's a M.Pharm, okay. Now currently he's taking care of all the research center needs of pharma industries with respect to the instruments. Sanjeev, apna audio mute kar dijiyega, please. Yeah. So he takes care of all the pharma R&Ds. Jinka jo bhi requirement hai with respect to the instruments that Janssen has. Also, he's a great mentor for all of us who are working with pharma literacy. So, any event of pharma literacy is incomplete without Deepak Singh being there. And since this is one unique initiative we started, 21 Days Masterclass, when I had this thing in my mind, 21 Days Masterclass, I was pretty sure I had to interview Deepak Singh on this platform. Okay. So of course, as well, Deepak, we'll be putting this video on YouTube channel as well as usual, like the entire conversation. So you are representing Janssen as well as the like the pharmacy, like you know, as such. So let me introduce you to our students batch. Actually, we are around 15 students. आज इतने सब लोग हैं नहीं, but then we have got people who are doing their masters. Batch of around 5 or 6 students from ICT who are doing their M.Tech or M.Pharm. Then we have got some B.Pharm students as well, the final year as well as second year students from Sinhagad College of Pharmacy. Then we have someone from, I don't know, Siddhi, which college, but then she's from Mumbai, final year. And of course, any event is incomplete without Deepak. Similarly, any event is incomplete without Dipali as well. Dipali, yeah. She's there today for the session, as well as one known face, like you know, is Mansi. She is a participant for this particular event. Okay, so I'll be actually, you know, the way we are going to do is I'll be throwing up some questions for Deepak. Deepak is going to answer those questions. Okay, of course, my questions. I am representing all of you people. I'll be asking those questions which you would be more interested to know from Deepak. As well as, of course, if you have any questions, you can put it in the chat option. Jaise hum routinely karte hain, right? So Deepak, to start with, aap khud ke baare mein batao beyond the most eligible bachelor in Mumbai.
Yeah, thanks for the such a good introduction. Hello guys, everyone. Hi. First of all, my name is not Vijay Shivpuje, so I'm not that famous right now. You know, I would love to be famous like you know him, but like I said, you know, yeah, I'm involved in all the activities. I love to work with Vijay sir. Now, initially, he has introduced me. I've completed my master's in pharmaceutics. Initially, I joined Microlabs as a research scientist. After 2.5 years, I thought, you know, I'm wasting my time or maybe I'm wasting my career. So I decided to shift from R&D to marketing. And that's the reason I went into Janssen's. The Janssen's is a pharmaceutical equipment manufacturer. So right now I am taking care of R&D, that is known as research and development sales for international markets and domestic markets. So this is what I do in Gansus. It's a 70 years old company who deals with the manufacturing of tablet coating machines, fluidized bed dryers, sifters, multi-mills, everything. Okay. I hope this works. I hope this works.
Yeah. Yes, Deepak. So Deepak, one particular question is, what made you prompted you basically from a kind of a safer zone, like R&D setup, mein, research setup, mein aap kaam kar rahe. Everyone wants to go for research work actually, all of the students, UG, PG level, pe jo hai, all of them usually want to go to research. But then from research, what was that trigger you felt like, not happy with this and I need to move on with something which is, I believe, more challenging?
Okay, first I would tell party bills, the bills, party bills. Now, on a serious note, I will tell you, my intent to change came from you only. Okay. You remember you started CLDP session in Micro Labs. Okay. Mm-hmm. I knew, my teacher used to tell me that I was very good at giving presentation, but when I moved into research, I was a shy guy. In terms, I was a kind of introvert. But when you started those sessions, when I felt ki, this is my area I should work in. And at that moment I thought, I don't think I'm made for research. I should go in some field like marketing or, technical presentations and everything. So that is the first foremost thing where I showed my intent to myself that I need to change. And then second, challenging because you get the reward as well. Reward is higher. And that is the reason the role is challenging. Third, I always tell ki, yes, my party bills is also one of the main thing, because in the initial stage, if you are earning, say, X amount of package, and after 10 years, you're getting a good package, that doesn't make any sense because you're wasting your 10 years. So that was also one of the most important parameter for me to have a change. So it is a cumulative one, but majority one, I think I felt it was from you. That I had it in me. This is a time for risk taking, and I took the risk. And luckily, in a touch wood, it's been 4 years I've been working with Gansus. And I hope to do wonders.
Yes. Deepak, just one thing I wanted to know. Do you think your association or your working with the research career with Micro Labs actually helped you in terms of your current profile?
I think it is 100 and we cannot call 101%, but I will tell you 100%, because right from the interviews, right from till now in Gansus, I can easily say that I am a technical person because I know the technical terms. So every technical term was taught at Micro Labs. Even if you see like from innovator characterization, dossier, PDR, every word, because if you see Gansus is dealing with pharma companies because we are making machines. So end user is pharmacist, and if you know the language of pharmacy, it is very easy for you. So I think 100%, every granulation, maybe it may be innovator, it may be PDR, it may be IPR, it may be regulatory affairs. I can now proudly say that I have come from Micro Labs, and because there are no person previously working in those organizations. They were basically engineers, so they didn't know anything about what is humidification. What is dehumidification? So technical terms, not. So I was the one, I used everything because we are into the quarters. So what are the products? I know the products because I've already worked on 30, 40 products. So that made easier for me.
Okay. And how was the transition on a professional front, basically? How was the transition from a research setup to a kind of a marketing job?
Yeah, I tell you, it was very difficult for me initially 6 months. In 6 months, I thought I would not be able to cope this pressure, because when you go for marketing and sales, there's a huge pressure of numbers you have to bring in. Okay, in R&D, you can take 6 months, 1 year, 2 years, you can develop a product, and if one product fails, also you get another shot at that. Not a problem for that. So in R&D, it was a white collar job kind of thing, and it was a bit relaxed. But when I switched initially, it was a really difficult for me because the engineering terms was very difficult for me. I don't know what is VFD, that's variable frequency drive example. But then I understood my strong point is my technical. not my engineering. So I should work rather than on my strong points rather than cribbling on this engineering terms. And that is where I turn my tables. You know, after 6 months, I realized that my take towards this organization is technical. So there were a lot of problems coming in from Sun Pharma, Dr. Reddy's. I went in, I told my MD that I can solve this. I know this. And that is how I created a path in our organization. So initially it was very difficult for me. I thought I would not be able to make it maximum 6 months. And I thought I would be back in R&D. But then after 6 months, when I realized what are my strengths rather than my weakness, it helped me really a lot. So that was one thing. You know.
And in those 6 months, like then, how did you actually like, you know, keep you yourself pumped up or okay, Deepak, you just continue with this just another some time, like, you know, jise hum, like, you know, the initial time mein, jo difficulties face with, as you mentioned, for
yeah,
felt like you should move back, like, you know, during that time, how did you actually deal with it?
Yeah, so I'll share a story, you know, one story. So it was like 15 days initially, there's a training session. So in 15 days, there's a training session. So you get to learn new products or whatever products are there in that organization. So I got to learn everything. Now, suddenly after 15 days, my boss says, okay, now you go into the field. Okay, now you go into the field. So it was the 16th day, I went into the field. Now just imagine when I went there, I was waiting for client. Then client called me inside. And he just bombarded me with, I can't really speak those words, you know. He bombarded me with bad words. He said, take your machine back. I don't want this machine. What is this? I mean, that was my first visit to a client. And I didn't know that this was, I didn't expect, because neither my sir told me, neither my colleagues. You know, I directly went in a state of shock. That was my 16th day. And I was like, I cried after coming out and went back to my home and I said, Mom, I'm not doing this for sure. I called my boss in my micro labs and I said, I'm coming. Then what he said, you know, initially at least, Deepak, try for 2 to 3 months at least. If you come back, you know, it would be very shameful kind of thing. No, don't come so early. You take your time and everything. So when I went back on the 17th day, I really felt bad. I told my boss, he said, it's not done. You should have told me, you know. So at that particular moment, my boss told me, you have changed from R&D to sales. Okay. I don't want a guy from a R&D background. I want a guy who can do sales. It was your job. Before going there, you should have gathered the information. It is not my job. You are doing, right? I'm your boss. You should have come to me. Sir, tell me what is it? You went directly. Okay, sir, multimill hai. It's okay, I can directly go because I know about multimill, I can talk about multimill. But you never knew what we supplied to them 20 years ago. Is there a complaint? Is there a complaint response? What is the response from Ganson side? So you didn't take any note and you directly went. So whose mistake is it? It's not yours. So that was the first time I realized on the 17th day, I made a mistake. Rather than now I can tell, yeah, it's my sir's mistake or it's my colleague's mistake, but that was my mistake. Beforehand, before going to there, I should have done my homework. And trust me, till now, whenever I go to visit any company, I take the history along with that so that it becomes easier for me, because see, they don't care. I've come on first day or 17th day. They will take me as a representative of Ganson's. So they can tell me before 20 years, I bought this. So me has to take a responsibility and take that I am talking on behalf of Ganson's. So that was the first instance where it was very bad. And I learned on the 17th day. That is the reason it gave me the energy. I'm learning something. Okay. It's my mistake, but I will learn something. Yes. So okay, let's try for 2 months. Let's push it, because initially we should not, you know, so easily we should not give in. So that was one thing that my boss was very supportive of that. No, he was not supportive. He was like, you have to do it by your own. So that took me certain things from surprise. And I thought, yeah, I'm here and this is going to be a real task for me. And from the days on and everything, this was the thing I kept it inside me and I kept learning few things. And it took me say 4 to 5 months. After 5 months, I realized more that my strength relies in technical terms, and that is the reason. Example, if you go for an interview, you know, they say, if you give an answer, and that answer can have a different question. So you should give an answer in a way that you can answer those question that has come from that answer. So similarly, I felt ki my strong point is technical. I had a lot of meetings. I brought in a lot of QA people. I explained them what are the regulatory guidelines, how the machine should be, what is quality, because they were not knowing each and everything. So that was a turning point for me. And from that time, you know, it took me at upward graph. The graph of mine took the upward. Yes. So yeah.
So now my next question actually, Deepak, is of course with respect to your first job as well as the second job, how significant is networking beyond your your sphere? When I say your sphere, it means for a student it may be just like, you know, your colleagues, your seniors in the college. Just thinking beyond your sphere, basically, how significant it is, as far as, because I know you more as an extrovert, get connected with any people very easily, like, you know, and me who was at some point of time was really an introvert. Then, but still, I want to know how significant is the networking per se in the in the industry, or like just as a student for that sake, you know, beyond your sphere.
I think networking is the most important parameter right now. If you're working and if you're talking about today's world, I think networking stands almost at the top. The reason I'll tell you, now example, I passed a master's from Vivekananda College, right? Mine was the first batch, master's of pharmacy and pharmaceutics. Mine was the first batch. We didn't have any seniors. And to the worst, I came from Pune University. So I didn't know anyone in Mumbai University. So that was a really difficult task with me. First, gelling is problem. And second, we didn't have any seniors. So what happens is, we always used to listen during our practicals in first year M.Pharm and second year, that only if R&D is one good job, only R&D. And if you go in anything else, you are gone. No pharmacovigilance. If you're going pharmacovigilance, you are very bad. You can't do anything. And you're not good at anything, and that is the reason you're choosing this. So this was the kind of network which we got through our colleagues, because, you know, we didn't have seniors, we didn't have networks. I had my network in Pune. So the good thing about that network was, in Pune, if you see 70% people work for industry, okay, they don't go for higher studies. If you see the margin in Mumbai, it is higher for higher studies rather than in Pune. So Pune, after masters, they prefer doing jobs in Kolhapur or maybe in Goa, you know. So that is where that network helped me. If you want to have a research kind of thing, go in R&D. But not because PV is bad, not because this is bad. Every perks, and everyone has a pros and cons. Whatever you feel is desire, you can go into that. So like I said, right from your seniors, once you have that network, it will be very easy for you. The reason I'm telling you, say suppose you are contacted with your seniors, and say after 2 years down the line, you feel that this job is not good for yourself. You realized. So because you will have a networking, you can talk to your seniors, and then seniors can help you. But if you don't have network, it would be very difficult for you, because you know 100 of people come and give you advice, right? 100 and people will give you advice. You can learn from everyone, but you need to understand at the age of 23 or 24, you're mature enough to know what your interest lies in. Then maybe at 26 or 27, which is a tender age, which they say, it's at that age, you can understand, yeah, this is not my cup of tea. Maybe this is my cup of tea. So, okay. So whom do you have? So you can go back. Oh, one of my seniors are working in this. So you can directly, can you imagine your whole life will change because of that network? So similarly, your network is very important, according to me. Right from your college, I can see RX happening. So a lot of event managers and everything, they manage the network. The network is highly strong. You know, I was like, oh my God, during my third year, I used to not speak to my colleague, and here people are managing RX and all the shows. So for me, networking is very important for maybe a changing of your life, or maybe to let you know the interest of your life in future.
Yes. Any of the students have any questions? Of course, I have lots of other questions for him. But any of the students can put the questions on chat, or maybe start the audio and ask the questions directly to Deepak. So he's part of our Pharma Literati family.
Yeah, you don't have to worry about Vijay sir. You know, you can directly ask me a question.
Yes. We got one question. This is really cool. Sheetal is asking, how did you get to know about Janssens?
You know, it was in party. So, you know, it was during a party. So do lots of parties, guys. Jokes apart, but seriously, it was on a party. We were having a house party of one of the colleague who shifted from Pune. That was Saurabh Shinde. He came from Pune and he joined Janssens first. And he took one BHK at a nearby location and he called me, I am in the Mumbai, I've shifted into Mumbai, you come in for the house party. And that's where I heard Janssens. And that's where he convinced me, this is good. But initially I was like, I'm happy with my R&D because I always wanted to go in research. But I never felt, we are doing a generic research. We are not doing an innovative research. When I came into R&D, I found that after 2.5 years, that we are only doing copy paste or maybe cut copy. So it's basically a generic division. And that prompted me to think more strongly on that view of Saurabh's, you can come in this field because I think you have a great sense of technical presentations, knowledge, and that will help you out. So this is the way I got in touch with Saurabh to get to know with Janssens.
So actually Deepak is suggesting everyone to have more number of parties so that actually you can come to know. So that is one of the ways to network as well, right?
Yeah, like Vijay sir is telling, the most important thing I love about this Pharma Literati is, I mean, at this age, I've seen Dipali. I'm just taking name. I've seen Dipali. Vijay sir doesn't give me any penny to promote his activity, so don't worry, I'm not doing it. But the thing is, I have seen Dipali. At that age, I was like very introvert. I was like, even if I know something, I was very afraid to tell. But this is a time you have to be extrovert and you have to have a good network. So I think Pharma Literati is a networking tool for you guys, for upcoming entrepreneurs and everything. Just to showcase your talent and don't get afraid of anything, Come and just show your talent. Maybe you can help. You have mentors like Vijay sir. You have mentors like us who can help you and who can help you to change your life as well. Maybe that can change your life, the decision. So yes, that's good.
Yeah, and
yes, sir.
Deepak, never ever ask for any single penny from Pharma Literati. We're still not in that position.
Okay. I always ask, but I don't get it. So it's okay.
Okay. So we have back-to-back questions. One is, how did you get job at Microlabs? To be very precise, as well as how did you get an entry into Janssens?
How did I get into Microlabs? So Microlabs, I'll tell you now, people talk about struggles. Okay. I completed my MPharm in 2013. Okay. 2013 September. From September, I was always interested in research. I got a lot of offers from pharmacovigilance and clinical data management, but I declined it. So in the month of September, one of my colleagues, she got a job in Microlabs. So I told, what you can do is you can just carry my resume and you can give it to your sir, me, if luck is okay with me and I'll get a job, no problem. So she said, okay, no problem. So September, she gave it, she gave the resume to her assistant manager. And that assistant manager threw that resume in his locker, in his drawer, in front of her. That's what she said. And she said, okay, if there would be something, they will let you know. Okay. So meanwhile, October, November, I went to college. Now in college, a lot of people were asking, sir, why are you coming? Your MPharm is over. I said, no, I want to participate in sports, one more year. I want to dance. I want to, enjoy my bachelor kind of thing. So in month of November, I felt very bad when a lot of people were asking, you are facing a lot of difficulties, sir. Why are you not getting a job? Is MPharma bad? So I was getting a lot of chins from my juniors. At that moment, I said, "Ki, it's okay. It's not my time, maybe, you know, because I want my R&D. I will wait for that." So I learned a software known as QBD, that is quality by design, okay, in my free time. Now, because of that, that girl called me in the month of February, "Ki, Deepak, I have a problem in QBD." And I solved that problem for her. The problem was of the manager, not of her. So manager said, "Who solved it?" So she said, one of my friend. "Okay, so do you have his number? Call him." So she said, "You know, that same guy whose resume is lying in the drawer. So you can..." Oh my God. And this is how I got a call from Gansons. "Can you come and give the interview? Because you know about QBD, you can come and join." So yeah, in short, what I want to tell you is, I was at home for 6 months after my M-Farm. So guys, nothing comes easy. But at that time, I studied something which was unique. So right now, 15 people, you are competitors. We are competitors. You should have some uniqueness. You should share your knowledge, not a problem, but you should have some uniqueness so that, you know, you can tell, yeah, you can say that, yeah, I can do this, I cannot do this. So that was the moment how I get into the micro labs. Yeah. Yes, sir.
In fact, I would like to repeat what Deepak said. As an individual, 15 years back when I did my master's, at that time, though, master's was a big thing, actually, M-Farm.
Absolutely, yes.
But then I also waited for almost 8 months to get my first job. But then what I got was something which I wanted, actually. So I waited for 8 months. And the best part is, as you mentioned, Deepak, your juniors were kind of teasing you and all. For your information, I was the only candidate. Probably I am the only candidate abhi tak, jisne apne junior batch ke saath campus mein participate kiya tha.
Okay.
So entire junior batch was there, and I am the only one from senior batch who participated in the campus. Okay, for one of the biggest companies in India. Of course, that couldn't work out. But like as you mentioned, patience is something that is required. Of course, we have got lots of questions more on the how to get a job and all. So Siddhi is asking, what is that one thing you must keep in mind while entering as a fresher? I think part of this is already covered, Deepak. But then,
yeah.
One good question coming from Indraneel, which is specifically for marketing. He's like, in marketing jobs, after some years, your output becomes stagnant. So you should change company after 4 or 5 years or certain period of years. So you will receive more salary because of increase in hike and experience. What is your take on this? And in marketing field, we should stick to one company or change it periodically?
Yeah, see, I'll answer the first half. I think it's the opposite. I will tell Indraneel, it is opposite directly. If you want to have a good salary, go and keep on changing your jobs initially. You know, I'll explain you how. Because initially your package is, example is 3 lakhs or maybe 4 lakhs or maybe 5 lakhs. So initially, if you jump, you can go up to say 10 lakhs or 11 lakhs quickly in 5 to 6 years. But after that, your slab increases. So every company has its own slab. So say example, you after 5 years, your package is 11 lakhs and you go for an interview. That company will see your experience. So suppose he will see your experience as a 6 years and you're getting 11 lakhs. So one thing he will be like, "Oh my goodness, I have workers who are more experienced than you, but they are earning say 8 lakhs or 9 lakhs. So I think you should not come here." Secondly, downfall this is, if you keep on changing job, they will say you are not, what I can say,
stable.
Or if I take you in the company, there's no chance, there's 50% chance or 60% chance that after say 6 months or after 8 months or after 1 month, after 1 year, you can leave the job. So if a company HR, they have been trained, whenever you take a recruitment, you should take that what employee will give to the component, what employee will give to the company. So example, initially first year, the company gives to employee. You learn the ifs and buts, you learn the guidelines and everything. And then from second year, we start giving back to the company. We start giving back to the organizational growth. So like I said, there should be a balance between both of them. Initially, like I said, it's for me, it's been 7 years of total experience and only have changed two companies. One is Microlab and one is Gansons. I'll tell you one thing. Initially, my package at R&D was very low. Okay, when I moved into R&D from R&D to Gansons, it was okay. It was well taken. No, not a problem. But in Gansons, in 4 years, I think if I would have been in R&D, it would have taken me 10 years to reach that package. Right now, I'm at what package I am. So what I want to tell you is, it all depends on yourself. If you can stick to that one company, if you can know what you are good at, you can play that card and you can become an important member of that. So continuously you have to update yourself continuously. Like you said, after 3 years, 4 years, you know, people, your boss will think, sorry, he is doing the same thing. He's not giving me any extra points. So definitely he will tell, I don't want him. So like you should keep yourself updated. You should be extrovert. You should be learning new things. You should be throwing new ideas to your managements, and you should have a say in your managements. That would be a good idea for right now. Okay. And second, what is your take on this? I am marketing field. We should stick one company. Like I said, it depends on the individual. There are people whose aim is to earn a lot of money. So initially, there are my friends who at say initially 5 to 6 years, they have changed almost 10 companies. But then I said, that's good for them. It's working for them. But that doesn't mean it will work for you. Because he is good at communication. He is good at, you know, telling lies and everything. So he can go for that job. But if you're doing a research, it won't be applicable for you, because there you have to have 2 years, 3 years. You have to learn the products. You have to finish the products. You have to scale up the product. And then you can go for a new company.
Yes, absolutely. In fact, so there are no set rules, basically, first of all.
Yes.
It all depends on you as an individual. And there was one very nice point that Deepak mentioned herein is, you have to keep reinventing yourself. Getting a job is not the end of your career. It is a long career of 35, 40 years. You have to kind of survive that as well as grow it during that tenure. Okay. So we have one question, Deepak. What is the current correct scenario for R&Ds as well as R&D cells? And what educational qualifications would you suggest to enter typically in R&D cell? Would you like a student to go for, let's say, a job directly? Typically for your kind of job, there are three options. One, a BFarm student entering Gansen or your kind of job. Second option is doing his master's, typical master's, MFarm karke, then entering this domain. Or the third option is BFarm plus MBA and then entering your domain.
Okay, now I'll just say the first of the question, what is the correct scenario about the R&D sales? Now, yes, I think this is the right time, you know, because of the coronavirus, you know, people have been talking about, rather than to invest on statue, you should invest it on healthcare. So if you see in the coming days, it would be like the governments will be investing huge amount in healthcare individuals, in R&Ds, in CROs for the research activities. So I think this is the right time because you will get a lot of subsidiaries as well. Secondly, educational qualification, I'll tell you after BFarm. Now, as per my experience, I'll tell you after BFarm, you can directly come in Gansons. You can work for 2 years. Okay. Right. After BFarm, you can directly come into Gansons. You can work. And then you can go for an MBA. Okay. And then again, you can come back to Gansons, or again, you can go anywhere else, because that will fetch you a minimum package of 8 to 10 lakhs. And that will give you an edge over others because you will be having an experience. So a lot of people, I think, if they have fixed here, my interest is in marketing, they can directly go after BFarm 2 years as a job and then go for master's in MBA. The one who are decided, I want to go in research, they can directly go in MFarm and then they can join it. So these are the two ways I'm dealing.
Okay. Deepak, of course, since you mentioned about the corona or COVID-19, like coming to kind of a personal, on a very personal note or personal level, actually, how have you been dealing with the lockdown since last almost 1 month?
See, it's been very difficult for us because we are a manufacturing company, but we cannot keep a hand on our head and sit like this, you know. So what we are doing is whatever orders we have got, okay. So we have relaxed the payment terms.
we are giving a new payment terms to the organization, to the clients. What we have been doing is we are giving the drawings, whatever documentation is required, we are doing right now, okay? Because they also know the situation. A lot of clients initially took, no, I'm canceling the order because, you know, I know you cannot give the on time. So for that, what we did is, say we have a manufacturing strength of 100 people. What idea we threw is, we have applied for the permission with the collector. We said, we will divide this 100 engineers into 30-30 each. And we will run 3 shifts a day. Okay? 8 hours per shift. And so that whatever is important for me, I will only, that 30 people will only produce that machine. And will give it in return with that. To this, client said, oh, this is a good idea. If you can do this, that would be good. And the secondary effect about the payments, we said initially, now you should pay us the remaining amount, the 60%, so that we can do this on the higher stage because the funds in the market is very less. So my vendors who are giving me HMIs, who are giving me the utilities and everything, they want in advance because right now there is no funds in the market. So that is the reason I wanted to help for those orders to the clients, you can, if you can just speed up the payment and everything. So they did that as well. So these are the few things which we are carrying out, you know, different models we are acclimatizing to, depends on the market condition. We have not got the permission till yet because they are saying if you are calling them, you should have a facility in the company only. So that is one major problem. But we are developing new models in terms of how to give a more discounts. So we are doing it. Yeah.
Yeah. So that's what we call as a reinventing, like the way you have reinvented with the new beard.
I never knew, you know, that you would be posting this video, you know, otherwise I would have shaved, you know, I look much better, but you know, that's okay.
No, but I think I have already commented that he's one of the most eligible bachelors in Mumbai that we have got in.
I think that is the most biggest returns you can give me, you know, on this stuff. It's okay.
Okay. So okay, Deepak, or ghar pe aap, means how are you, how is your day scheduled during the lockdown? Kaise, how are you managing the things?
See, we are very occupied, you know, because the sales guys, you know, I tell you what we have developed, my CMD's machine. One sec, I'll just take one sec. I'll just. Okay, sorry for the trouble.
Yeah.
Now I'll tell you one thing, what our organization, because this is a small company, Gamson is a small company, we are a 70 years old company, humanity. So what our CMD told, you know, daily call 5 clients and ask them, how are you? Ask them how are you doing? Don't ask them about the money. Don't ask them about the client. The one who is not given us the orders, okay? Ask them, call them. And the one who has given you the previous orders, call them. How are you, sir? Are you good? Sir, this has created havoc here. Engage them on a personal level. Trust me. We have got almost every day they are calling us for 10-15 minutes. Hello Deepak, I'm glad that you, being a vendor, you called me, you know. So this is one human connection which I never knew. So this is reinvention. You know, one of my meetings, you know, CMD said, and this you have to do. And I'm right now, I am receiving from 9 o'clock to 12 o'clock, I receive the client's different calls. And then from 12 to 12:30 or 1 o'clock, I make presentations. From 1 to 5, we have a Zoom calls because whatever we can do on Zoom calls, we are doing it in terms of URS, in terms of system acceptability, in terms of documentation. And then after 5 to 6, we are on the calls again to discuss about overseas project. So this is how we are keeping ourselves engaged. We are reinventing ourselves, whatever we can do on human level. You know, because I think more than money right now, humanity is more important for us.
Yes, absolutely. In fact, like, you know, as your CMD rightly mentioned, even I have been following this, like, you know, since almost the lockdown started, I've been calling people every day, 2 to 3 people, my old friends, old colleagues, kind of an opportunity to networking as well. Deepak, I have one very interesting question, actually. Again,
yes, sir.
So looking at your ambitious attitude as well as the personality, do you have any plan to have your own setup or company? If yes, then what kind of company it would be?
Can you just repeat it again? Can you just repeat it again?
Yes, Deepak. So looking at your ambitious attitude,
okay,
as well as personality,
okay,
it feels like immense. That thought came in his mind that probably you would be starting your own company or a setup at some point of time. What type of company you would be choosing?
Okay, now, yeah, first part, looking at ambitious attitude, well, thanks for that. I always wanted to have a startup, you know, but the thing is Vijay Shiv Puja is not giving me the time or, you know, not finding me appropriate tool for me to do that. That is one of the most important parameter. That is the reason.
Deepak, you are being a mentor to, like, you know, startups or small ventures like us. Like,
yeah. But what best than you? You know, at the age of 38, you resigned from a well settled job. You know, guys, he had a great salary, he had a great future behind him. But at the age of 38, I shifted at the age of 27. You know, so the risk is lesser, but at the age of 38, the risk is very huge because you have to feed your families, you have responsibilities and everything. So that was a tough call for you. But seeing you have so well, and whatever innovations which we are doing, whatever parameters, whatever functions you are doing, we are involved. But I always wanted, you know, if I can solely work for you, that would be that is my ambition, that is my aim, you know. I think we should work on it.
What kind of company you are going to start, Deepak? Then
see, if you ask me, I'll set up a consultancy based system. Now, being in this market for say 4 years, there's a lot of money in trading and consultancy. There is a lot of money, okay, and less hiccups. So I'll tell you, because I have an experience of R&D, I have an experience of machines, I can go in a consultancy service where I can have a new products like blowers, like mills. I can just be a representative of one and I can sell it in India. Secondly, I can be a consultancy example, you know, plant. Whenever a pharmaceutical industry is getting inaugurated or the plan is done, they have a consultant, okay, who take care of the plant layouts and everything. So because I have that knowledge, you know, I can be there, I can tell them what is needed because I have set up already 5 to 6 plants overseas in Egypt, in Germany. I can set up the plant. So I can have my own unit. You know what hefty amount they get? 1% of the total value. So if total value is 500 crores, I'll get 1%. So just imagine the amount of money. And whatever you're doing is you have to use your experience. You have to share the layouts. You have to tell them, no, this is to be like this. This is to be like this. This should be done like this. This should be done like this. So I think right now I would have a trading kind of business or a consultancy kind of business. I would love to it because of my experience, because of my networking. That would be good.
We have one technical question from Sanjeev. He's asking, like the formulation or the typical pharma companies usually follow the pharmacopoeias or the standards. Do you have any standards with respect to the instruments that you prepare?
Yeah, IMA. There's a IMMA. There's an Indian Manufacturing Machine Association. We follow it. Then there's ASIA, quality of stainless steel. Then we have ASME codes, American safety measures codes. Then we have CE guidelines. So for that, yeah, we have to maintain these guidelines. These are the equipment guidelines. You know, example, I'll say the machines are 2-bar. Okay? All the machines which are in the market are of the 2-bar design. Why it is 2-bar? Because atmospheric pressure is 1, right? Double that bar. The atmospheric pressure, generally the atmospheric pressure is 1-bar, correct? So if your machine, say tomorrow, it can have a blast, correct? So what is the safety? So your machine should be capable of double. Your machine should capable of withstanding that pressure double. So that is 2-bar. So example, we do have guidelines, you know, like ASME guidelines, CE guidelines, UL guidelines. There are guidelines available.
Are there any specific guidelines which are directly connected with the pharma industry, pharmaceutical industry?
No, right now. Right now, I think I have heard that US FDA is coming up with the thing is US FDA can audit vendors as well, like us. So example, Cipla has Janssen's machine, they can directly come to vendors. But till now, we don't have any guidelines coming in from the colleges or companies. We don't have any guidelines.
Okay.
But in future, we might have.
Yes, yes. Of course. As we have got more stringent regulation. One interesting and probably the last question that we have is, from the students is, what are those technicalities that you would suggest the student specifically to be sound to have a career in techno commercial field?
Okay, pertaining to techno commercial, first, you know, start speaking. You know, I think most important thing I always keep telling myself is confidence, you know, and this one thing I would like to tell them, you know, that you are the best. So what you can do is, you know, in front of your mirror, you can go and you can tell 10 times that I am the best. You know, nothing for someone else, you know, but for yourself just to understand. Yeah. And everyone is different. So you can start from one is confidence, develop your confidence. Second, start speaking. Even if you fumble, it's okay. Start speaking and start thinking. A lot of times what happens is we are accustomed to theoretical thinking. If you look at the abroad people, why they are more better than us in terms, because they have a practical approach. Okay. That is the reason. If you see Mumbai University is now in MPharm, they are having a practical as well. So the more practical you will have, the more you will see a solution to a problem rather than a problem. This is my take. Once you are into the theory, you will only talk about the problems. But once you think practically, you will think about the solution. You will think, okay, now I can go. Now, example I'll give you. You know iPhone, right? You know iPhone. iPhone right now it is X. iPhone is 11, right? There's one book called Out of Box Thinking, which says right now Apple has everything till iPhone 17. They are 6 years ahead, maybe 6 or 7 years. They have iPhone 16 or 17, correct? They know what they are going to do in iPhone 16 or iPhone 17. Just imagine at this 2020, they are working on 2027. So the futuristic approach. So this one thing, you know, practical approach, futuristic approach is very important for guys like this young people. You are very energetic. Don't be impulsive. I think don't be impulsive. Be patient. You know, it took me 6 months. It took eight months, I think, to Vijay sir. So even if it takes you 1 year, don't lose your patience, you know, but understand one thing, whatever you love, do that. Whether it may be depending on your courses or whether it may be Rangoli, whether it may be everything can be earned. Everything can be earned. I'm telling you, even if you prepare a lot of Rangoli, develop a channel, Instagrams, do it, you know, YouTuber, everything, you can earn a money. Not a problem. Okay. But you should know how to do it. You can do anything if you want.
Thank you so much, Deepak. You can give a shout out for our YouTube channel, Family Trading.
No, I've been checking Pharma Literati Instagram and everything. I'll tell you one thing, you know, the guys are really working very good. I think this is a good platform. The young people can go and check it out. I mean, you can check out the post from last year as well. It will be useful for you. They have been conducting sessions. They have been conducting workshops. I am pretty impressed with that. You know, it's not a one kind of approach. You are keeping open 10 or 20 things, you know. So any guy who wants to fill in or who wants to work, you are taking them as a trainee. You are exposing them. I think this is a really good thing, you know, whatever you are doing. So all the best to Pharma Literati, and I hope my collaboration stays forever with you.